celebrate with them. Or you feel like, I'm leaving. Some people have left church because they felt that God is delaying. It's easy to judge them because they have left. But your time of test is coming. Your time of waiting is coming. I remember when I was in Malawi, after we had our first child, my wife was expecting. She was about 4 months, and she was staying in another city, which was about 4 hours from where I was staying. She'd be traveling every Friday night, 5 o'clock, by bus, to meet me in the Lilongwe, would arrive midnight, Friday. Sunday, after service, 1 o'clock, she has to travel back to Blanta, another 5 hours. And because of that trip, she miscarried. And that was a serious, serious challenge for her. We tried. 1 year, no child. Doctor said everything is okay. 2nd year, no child. 3rd year, no child. 4th year, no child. But we are praying for other people and they are receiving babies. But they are not receiving any baby. And every time when the date when she miscarried would come, my wife would always say, my son would be 2 years old now. Even now, she still goes through that. I have forgotten, but she can't forget. What has waiting done to you? On the 5th year, we were in Swaziland. She conceived. Now, on the 2nd month of her conception, I was preaching and I said to the church, I believe that my wife is carrying a boy. Because I've always wanted a boy. And I thought the first one would be a boy. And even the scans, they said he was a boy. Until the day she was born, and the nurses came and said, congratulations, you are now a father to a bouncing baby girl. I said, no, mine is a boy. But God had another plan. So this time, I stood in the pulpit and I said, the Lord is going to bless me with a child. And he's going to be a boy. And his name will be Gosenti Junior. When I went to sit down, the devil said to me, what a big blunder. Because it's going to be another game. And you've just told the whole church. You have kept it to yourself so that you don't get disappointed. I was holding on to my promise. And I trusted God in a risky environment. Guess what? This boy was born. And this boy was born 2 days before my birthday. They died still believing that has waiting caused you to be like? We struggle in our churches. When we have incurable diseases like HIV and AIDS, we've got cancer. When the faith is shaken, then our people will be found in the witch doctor's house. Our people will be found drinking different things that are not in line with the word of God. Because of the weight, they've been prayed for, they've been declared healed, but no manifestation. Are you ready to lose your salvation just so that your body is healed temporarily? There is a condition that is worse than the issue of blood, and that is the condition of sin. While she was losing her blood and losing life, there are people who are losing their spiritual lives by living in the dark and not choosing light. They are in captivity. They are living a life that they don't want to live. They are making choices that they really don't want to make, but because they are bound, their will doesn't matter anymore. Struggling to make it in life, but not making it. Some are dead men walking. Spiritually, they are dead, but physically, they are alive. I want to challenge you, don't die twice, die once. For if you die once, in the physical, know that you are born again, you know you shall live in eternity with God. But children of God, let's not lie to ourselves. All of us have been given an opportunity to choose life. But some will choose death. I want to speak to those who are here tonight. You know your life is not right. But you see, because we have to keep an appearance, we have to make people happy, we have to pretend that things are in order, but you know virtue, power is going out of you. It's a condition that a good outfit will not cure. It's a condition that money will not cure. It's a condition that perfumes will not quench the stench of sin. It's a condition that you may hide from people, but the eye of God will judge you. The Bible says, Jesus did not come to condemn us. He came to save us because God loves us. Could that be you? You thought you were in the church, but you're still in the crowd. I want to invite you tonight. Get out of the crowd. Stop worrying about people's perceptions and think about you. Child of God, there is a time that whatever you want will not be given to you. You know that when you die, even your burial outfit, somebody will choose it for you. You might want your knight's head, but they might grant you a duke and put the duke on you. You are dead. You can't choose for yourself. Somebody will close your eyes when you're dead. And the money you are saving, somebody will chow it in the manner they want. The house you so value, somebody will take over the house, whether you like it or not. Or the nice Porsche car you ride in, somebody will have a wing riding on it in the streets of Pretoria, whether you hated them or not. because now we are in a condition where you can't come back. That is life. But while we are here, we are worried about making people think good about us. Worry about what God thinks about you. Because all of us are at the bus station. We are waiting for this bus that takes us to eternity. Children of God, if there is eternal life, there is also eternal death. If there is eternal life, there will be eternal death. The only difference is you choose while you are alive. Jesus could not save us in heaven as a spirit. He needed a body. For him to be physical and die in the physical and save men in the physical. Demons and the devil cannot repent because they are spirits. They don't have a chance because they are not in the physical. Salvation is only acquired when you are in your body. Once your spirit leaves, as Africans say, he is gone, uhambile, meaning you are there physically, but your spirit is gone. All they are trying to say, the real you is gone. When you get out of your body, the chance of repentance is no more. I know what we do. We light a candle, and we say the candle will light your way into heaven. That is a lie from the pit of hell. Salvation is only found when you are in the body. That's why Jesus had to find a body and die in the body to save people who are still in the body. Amen. When the spirit leaves your body, your fate is sealed. I know in some of the churches where we were, we pray for the dead so that they can get appeasement, and we do penance for them. That is a lie from the devil. We believe in ancestors. In my country, in Swaziland, when you die, we will call you and tell you that you are now going to your ancestors. But remember the man Lazarus and the rich man. When the rich man died, he said, can you please ask Lazarus to go tell my brothers that they should choose better and not come where I am. Let me be the only one from my father's house who suffers this torment. Let them choose better. And the word was given, even if he is to rise from the dead, they will not believe. But there are people who are preaching the gospel. Let your brothers hear and repent. Sometimes you hold on to our ancestors, and maybe they could be in torment crying. Don't choose like we chose. Don't behave like we behaved. I have to pray. Today I'm talking to those who need to reconcile and come back home. Come to Jesus. Make peace with God. If that is you, please come. I'm waiting for you. While everybody is watching,